Irene, I'm going to do this. And Irene's just having a gasket. She's blowing a gasket. Don't. That's her boyfriend. Don't. I'm like, no, this is the way it works. And so I said I was going to reverse it and send something to Ben from Sierra.
I'm smiling.
So lady.
Give me, whoa, your love. Lady, from the moment I saw.
Okay, so I said, that should be enough, but this is Sierra's response.
I'm going to kill you when I get home. I'm just going to stay in China and never come home. You're dead to me. Did you just not answer me? It's like 9 at home. Pick up. Mom, take that phone and tell Ben that that is not from me. That's from him. Ugh, we're headed to the Summer Palace. I probably won't be on Wi-Fi all day. If you traumatize Ben and he breaks up with me, just give me a heads up. Thanks.
And he stuck it out.
I'm glad to see Sierra and Ben to have each other and to hold and to fart and be old. I'm excited for you and Ben to spend the next chapters of life and making it your own. You Yinzers, which is a term because they're from Pittsburgh, have many blessings coming your way. I'm always a trip, a phone call, anywhere you need me, just call me. Ben, I look forward to being another sister to you and share family times together, and it's been so much fun meeting your family as well, especially Lucy.
When Ben came to me and said, I am moving to New York City for a career full time, I said, that's the last I've ever seen of this guy. But he succeeded. He's still alive, mostly, and I think he's living proof that sometimes good things happen to good people. And that's where Sierra comes into play. Sierra, you're one of the best and most genuine people I've ever met. I don't say that lightly. It's been a pleasure to get to know you, to see the way you and Ben work together, to help you demolish old closets in your house. You bring light into pretty much every space you enter. But when Ben told me he was going to propose to you, not even once did it cross my mind to ask if he was sure. I knew he was making the right choice. You guys are excellent together. Going back to, again, to what Sierra said to me after the rehearsal dinner, you are exactly where you need to be, my dude.
The other night, I was talking to Ben, and I asked him if he needed some time alone, because that's one of the characteristics of Ben, is he likes to go and be on his own for hours, or days, weeks. And he relayed to me a story where recently he was painting their house, some room or something, and Sierra was somewhere else. And he realized that he was in this house by himself, and he said, for the first time, I felt a little lonely. I wanted Sierra there to be with me. I could really use Sierra in this house with me. Well, buddy, guess what? You got her in the house now. Congratulations, Sierra. Welcome to the family. Ben, I love you, brother.
Lord Jesus, I pray that you would let your Holy Spirit rest on Ben and Sierra in a very powerful and meaningful way in their lives, that you would lead them day by day, ever closer to you and to each other, that they would have a love for each other that overflows into their interactions with others as well, those in your body and those outside. Just give them clear direction and an unwavering faith in you, we ask in your name, Jesus. Amen.
Father, I ask that your love and your light will shine brightly through these two, that their home, Father, would be just a refuge for others, and that you would show your light through them to this dark world.
In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we do declare, decree, and impart to you our blessing. That always and in all ways, your union will reflect the marriage of the bride and the Lamb. Amen.
Sierra, I commit to give you my full desire and affirmation. These are my adamant promises to you. Thank you for building our incredibly unique and important relationship with me over the last 3 years. Thank you for working through tough moments and conversations with me, for always trusting and being trustworthy even when it's hard to speak. Thank you for taking risks for and with me, for opening yourself up to the unknown with me from the very beginning. I'm so thankful for you and for the story we've started and the story we will continue to write. You have brought me so much delight, comfort, friendship, and laughter, but even for that, I know that none of this would have been possible without the help of a deeper spirit which calls us both to forgive, understand, and serve. Thank you for sharing this spirit with me. Every day, whether in the lofty highs of Scottish Highlands or in the dark depths of a New York subway station, I commit to giving my full desire and affirmation for the rest of my life. You lift my spirit every day I've known you, so let's make this official.
Dear Benjamin, you know I love song lyrics, so it's only fitting that I start this off with a few lyrics that have been rolling around in my head as of late. Have I known you 20 seconds or 20 years? You constantly make me feel this paradox. After 3 years to the day of dating you, I still feel all the excitement and emotion, the curiosity and wonder of first meeting you. Those feelings haven't faded for me. I may have 3 years of knowing you under my belt, but there is still so much to learn about and love on. I am ready and I am honored to be the girl that gets to learn about you for a lifetime. I love you. I love all of you. I love how much you care about your family and investing in your relationships with your family. I love your creative mind and your love of good art. I love that when you witness something beautiful, you talk about God. I love your gift of empathy. I love how it allows people to feel vulnerable and free in your presence because they know you are listening to them and feeling with them. I love when you get goofy, especially with me. I love watching you express yourself and letting those around you know your thoughts. There are so many elements of your being that I love. My heart is full of gratitude for you. Thank you for allowing me a space in that beautiful heart of yours. Thank you for letting me enter your space and take up your time. Thank you for responding to me and reacting to me. Thank you for saying yes to all of my crazy ideas, like renovating our house and getting married. Thank you for seeking God out and for pushing me toward Him when I get distracted and disillusioned by this world. Thank you for loving my family and for embracing them as your own. Thank you for loving me. The way you look at me, the way you talk with me, and the way you hold me, the way you invest in me make me feel insanely loved. In the presence of our friends and our family and the Lord our God, I'd like to make a few promises to you as your soon-to-be wife. I promise to first and foremost seek God above all things. I promise to listen to His Spirit and lean on God's guidance rather than my limited wisdom. I promise to build a family with you that invests in others and in good conversation and in God. I promise to open our home up to those who are in need and to work with you in God's good work. I promise to serve you by listening to you and asking honest questions. I promise to push you towards God, praying that He uses me to help guide you and love you. I promise to encourage you and to fight any thoughts about yourself that are not from God. The thoughts that say you are not enough, that you are not strong, or that you are not capable, I will fight them off with you and ask God to replace them with truth, that you are more than enough, and that God made you to lean on His strength, and that you are so incredibly capable of anything God puts in front of you. I'm so honored to witness all that God's doing through you. I'm shaken with humility at the man God has set before me as my husband. I now eagerly take your hand as your wife and your friend. My final promise to you, Benjamin, is that I will always be your friend. When life gets scary or overwhelming or complicated, I promise to invest in you first as my friend. Our friendship is more important to me than a romance. I promise to feed into our friendship and remember that before we were anything, we were friends. I'm eternally baffled and grateful at how God took this simple friendship and turned it into a beautiful marriage. Praise Him. Thanks for doing this with me, Benjamin. I love you so much.
So that all of us in the room are kind of on the same page, first of all, the Apostle John in 1 John chapter 4, verses 9 and 10, gives a beautiful summary of the gospel. The good news of God. And here's what he says. He says, "This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for the sins of the entire world." Really good news that we're separated from God because of our sin, but Jesus comes. Jesus bridges the gap. We have the opportunity to receive Jesus as Savior, and then, as it says in Romans chapter 8, verse 1, there is now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus.